batter Joshua inside the first round.
Salute to Nick Harmer, who's a real Tyson Fury fan. There's a difference between being a Tyson Fury fan and a fanboy. And we know what the other guy was. And I don't have a dog in this fight, but we all know Anthony Joshua has the best resume in the heavyweight division. And Dillian Whyte is second. Fury fanboys is just as bad as Wilder fanboys making these narratives up. What is this fascination with Derek Chisora? Fury fought Derek Chisora in his prime. And Derek Chisora's resume is pretty good. The problem with his resume is every time he stepped up in competition, he lost. The dude has 9 losses. Joseph Parker was a WBO heavyweight champion. He has 2 losses on his record. One of the losses is from Anthony Joshua in a unification bout, and the other loss is from Dillian Whyte. And he has a win over Andy Ruiz Jr., who's a top 5 heavyweight. Don't sound like a bum to me. And it's funny how Oscar Rivas is a bum, but John Swartz is not. Fanboys crack me up. I am quoting Anthony Joshua. He said he wants to break Fury's head and he will stop him within 6 rounds. Fury responds to that and says he will batter Anthony Joshua the first round. We don't believe that. Tyson Fury is not going to come after Anthony Joshua like he did Deontay Wilder. They're 2 different fighters. Joshua is a more skilled fighter than Wilder, and I believe if Fury does the same game plan they did against Wilder, then he will get knocked out. I think he'll fight Joshua early like he did against Klitschko. I'm just saying he's going to do that in the early rounds, and then he'll pick his shots later on. Joshua's team should make sure Anthony Joshua is focused on Pulev. Don't want any slip-ups there. If you don't beat Pulev, not mentioning it'll be a big upset, but if you don't beat Pulev, there's no multi-million dollar fight with Fury. Another false narrative that's going around is Anthony Joshua is being protected by Eddie Hearn because Eddie Hearn was forcing a fight between him and Whyte. But Whyte was his number one contender, so I don't know where that came from. AJ offered Tyson Fury a fight back in 2018. Fury turned it down. AJ wants a WBC belt, and whoever has it, that's who he wants to fight. See, I know what Fury's trying to do. Because Fury doesn't want to fight any mandatories, so he might be planning to give up the belt. And he probably feels AJ won't fight him if he gives up the belt. So now they make him a narrative that, oh, Anthony Joshua must be scared of Fury because he won't fight him. And I'm already hearing, oh, belts don't mean nothing anyway. I could buy a belt off eBay. What's a belt? I want to see the best fight the best. And that's coming from Fury fans because they know it's a possibility he may vacate that belt. But Anthony Joshua's goal is legacy. He wants to be undisputed heavyweight champion in the world, and he needs that WBC belt. But both guys got mandatory if Fury decides to keep the belt. I know Joshua got a couple of mandatories, so his fight might be pushed back even farther. At the least, we're waiting for 2021. I just hope these guys stay focused and take care of business, because the last thing we need is another mega fight ruined. Leave your thoughts and comments below. Jay Beezy, subscribe to the channel. I'm gone.